Okay, in the last video, we created the top, middle, and bottom layers. And we can click on these and I can show you that they're still here. So those are all of our layers. Now what we want to do is we want to add another layer, which will be our name. So in this example, you see Otis Collier. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do another layer. Now, when we're working with text, we don't have to create a new layer. When we click on the text automatically creates a new layer for us. So if you look over here to the right, you'll see that we're looking at the bottom background white layer at this point in time. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go over and I'm going to click on the text for the type tool. We'll click on that. And what we want to pay attention to is we want to pay attention to the font style, the size, whether we want it bold, regular, italics, and whatever our color might be. Now, remember that we're working with yellow here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to increase this size to a 50. And I want my color to be, I think I'm going to go with a black. Okay. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to just place our marker right here where we want the first name to be. So we'll click there. So we'll see that marker is there. And then if you look over here to the right-hand side, you'll see that it automatically created a layer. Now we won't name that layer right now. We just want to type in whatever it is that you want to type in the background. So I'm going to type in my name. Okay, so I've typed my name all the way across. Now what I want to do is I want to move this so that it's properly placed. So I'm going to go over and I'm going to select the Move tool. And then what I can do is I can actually move that. So I'm going to move that right about there. Now, you'll notice that this is a dark color. So what I want to do is I want to show you what we can do to our text here. And so it's very hard to see. So what I want to do first, I'm going to turn the yellow background layer back on so that we can actually see that. And then I'm going to go back up here to my text. And I'm going to right click on the layer here and I'm going to go down and I'm going to click on layer styles. Now under layer styles, there's several different things that I can do. I can create a drop shadow, and that looks a little weird because of the distance of the shadow. But if I click on drop shadow here, you'll see that I can change the distance here. So I can change that to anything that I like. Okay. I don't want to get fancy here, but I can do inner shadows, I can do bevel edges, outer glows, and just so many different things that I can do here. I'm not going to get fancy with this, I'm going to leave it as is, but there are some things here that you can do here. I'm going to close that out. What I want to do is I want to give it a faded look. If you'll remember, my first name was faded out where we looked at the original. So let me go back and just kind of show you that. If I undo this yellow and let me undo the wording here, you'll see how my name was faded out. Otis is faded out. So I want to do the same thing here with the black. The way that we do that is we right click on the layer again, and what we're going to do is we're going to rasterize the layer. So you'll click on rasterize the layer. And now you'll see that the opacity gives us an option where we can make this layer lighter. So what we're going to do is we're going to bring this down to say 50. And then I want to turn that yellow back on just to make sure that looks okay. Okay. So here we have our name rasterized with the yellow. And I probably want to move this over just a tad. Okay. All right, so that's taken care of. The next thing that we want to do is we want to do our last name. So we're going to select our text layer again, or our type tool. And once we select the type tool, we've got all of our type, font size, and our color selected. Then we're going to click over here again. And now we're going to type in our last name. Okay, we've got our last name typed in. I'm going to move that around so that looks like that. And now we've got our name selected. Okay, so now let's look at bringing my image in, the picture of myself standing up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to File, Open, and I actually have an image of myself where I'm standing. So I'm going to go to my Pictures folder, and I've got an image of myself here, and there I am. Now, as we look at this, this image looks a lot larger than what my banner background looks. Obviously, I'm going to have to adjust the size, maybe. The reason why I said maybe is because you have to remember we're at 65% on our background image, where the standing image is at 100%. So the first thing I want to do is I want to reduce this down to 65%. Now that I've reduced it down to 65%, I believe that's going to fit and look real nice right there on my image. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select my marquee tool, and I'm going to copy this whole image. Do an edit copy. Then I can close that image out. And then I'm going to do a paste. So I'll do edit, paste. And there's the image. Now, what I want to do with this image is I want to move it right where the other image is. So we'll move this image right here. Okay. Now let's turn on all of our other layers just to see how this looks. So I'm going to turn on my red layer. And I will turn on the white. And there's our image. Now, with our image, we can still do some things. And one of the things I like to do with my image is I like to give it a shadow effect. So we'll go back and right click and click on our layer styles. And we'll click on drop shadow. You'll see the drop shadow effect there. And I want to close in the distance a little bit. I don't want it to be so distant. But there we go. So now we've got our shadow. Now the only thing that's left for us to do is to add our social media buttons. So how do we do that? The first thing we want to do is we want to go to Google and we want to search on free social media icons. So I'm going to click on that, do a Google search. You'll see that there are several different links here for you to choose from. If you click through some of these, that's not found. If you click through some of these, you'll actually find a set of social media icons. So here's an example of social media icons that you could actually use. So for example, let's click on this. And this gives us a set of different types of icons. So here's hand-drawn doodled icons. Here's some additional icons. So what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to search around and find the icons that actually work for social media, that work for you. Here's a good set here, social bookmark icon sets. So all of these will work for you. You'll just have to scroll through and find some social media icon sets that actually work for you. Going to actually go back and take a look at one other link here. See if this brings us up anything different. And there we go. So we see that there are, there's Twitter, there's some other ones, LinkedIn, some interesting social media icons that you can actually use. So what you would do is you would just click on that. Let's just say we're going to click on the postage stamp. We would click on the postage stamp, and then we would actually download this to our computer. So we would just click on download, and we would download the social icon stamps to our computer. Okay, I'm going to end the video here, and in video 3, I'm going to show you how to add the icons to your YouTube background. And then from there, we're just going to upload your background to your YouTube channel.